What's up guys, it's Grant here and I'm giving away a Galaxy S9 Plus smartphone to one of you. There's a link down in the description to get your name on the list to qualify. It's a little subscriber appreciation for you. Love you guys, appreciate your support. Go get your name on the list to get qualified and all the best.
Hey guys, today we're gonna be finishing up the gear project that we started in a previous video. We managed to make a mold around a piece of foam using some drywall texturing paste, and then we stuck that into some sand and we cast copper down into it. We got this great copper gear, but it still looks very messy. So today we're gonna see what it takes to clean this up. We've got a bunch of sandpaper, we've got files, we've got metal brushes, we've got polishing wheels, and we've got metal polish, and we are just gonna hit this thing with everything we've got until we can get it nice and clean and just shiny. Like, I wanna be able to see my reflection in this bad boy. Will it work? I don't know. This is an experiment and we're gonna find out. I've got a 60 grit belt on our belt sander here. We're gonna see how much of this copper we can smooth down using the belt sander. It might be a little bit tricky because I do have quite a bit to get through before it's nice and smooth, but I think that's gonna be our best tool for this job. If this doesn't work, we'll see about moving on to something else. All right, that's just a few seconds on the belt sander. We can already see the progress we're making. We can also see that our copper is apparently like Swiss cheese full of holes. I'm not exactly sure what caused that or how deep those bubbles go, but I'm just gonna keep on going. We might be able to sand right through those, or maybe one side of our gear is gonna have a really cool decoration all over it. I can only think of one way to find out. Still getting flatter. You can still see those holes. Does look like some of them are pretty shallow, and I think we've almost gone all the way through them. I bet some of them are deep enough that they'll still show up in our final surface, but even just that, I really like how the copper is starting to show up there. It looks pretty cool. My wheel is also getting nice and hot. I'm gonna have to grab some water to cool this off in after a couple minutes of sanding, because it's gonna get warm doing this. But I'm liking it, it's working. I have only been doing this for like less than a minute already, and it's definitely making progress. So this sandpaper on the belt sander seems to be the way to go. Woo. All right, and kind of just like that, it is getting too warm to hold on to, so I'm just gonna get some cold water that I can cool this off in, and we'll dry it off and throw it back on the belt sander. Copper does conduct heat better than most, if not all, metals. It might not be the very best heat conducting metal, but it's really high up there. This has spread so much sanded copper out on the workbench. Look at this, you can just like making a pile. Back to the grind, literally. I think we've made pretty good progress on this side. We've definitely flattened it all out. You can see that the shiny copper is exposed all the way through. A lot of these bubbles on this side, but I think that's actually gonna be a pretty cool looking effect. We'll see how I decide to go about cleaning those up. It's time to move on to the other side, which is already quite a bit flatter, so I think it'll go pretty quick. And we'll see if there's any bubbles on this side too. I'm not sure yet. We've got both sides of our gear partially sanded down and they are looking good. Now I wanna try getting into the teeth of this. I'm not gonna be able to do that on the belt sander, so I'm gonna move over to our bench vise and start using some hand files and see if I can't clean up those edges a bit. We may come back to the files in a little bit for some more detail work, but for now we're gonna move on to using the wire brushes on this rotary tool, and we've got some that should fit in our regular drill chuck. So we'll try and see if we can clean up some of the edges that are harder to hit with a file. This little attachment may not be the sturdiest built thing ever. I think 60% of the wires have just torn themselves off polishing that copper right there. Hmm. At the end of the drill, I now have what is a wheel made of cotton or maybe muslin discs. And then I've got some polish, which I will apply to the cloth, and then I'll use that to try and really bring out a nice shine on the copper. My goal was to make a copper gear so shiny that I could see myself. How do you think I did? This method of casting copper is not 100% perfect. By pouring it in the way we did, we ended up with a lot of large bubble marks on the backside and a lot of small bubble marks on the front side, but it was still able to be flattened down, smoothed out, and polished. And like, I could use this thing as a copper colored mirror. It's a little small, but overall, it looks really good.
Hey, what's up guys? It's Grant here with a brand new Galaxy S9 Plus smartphone that I'm giving away to one of you for subscriber appreciation. I've got a link down in the description so you can get your name on the list and qualify to win.